Father, can you hear me now? I'm just one voice in the wind. When the lava meets the sea,
I'm Billy Kinoy, born and raised on the island of Hawaii. I'm honored and privileged to serve as the mayor of the county of Hawaii. So many people I grew up with, I live with, and I work with, or I have an opportunity to meet, who I respect and admire. Everybody's been through difficulty and hardship. Every person in their life, no matter how we think they've had it made and it's been perfect for them, every person I've met has to overcome some obstacle, some hurdle, some barrier in life. Might be financial, might be, you know, I know people who've lost their parents at a young age, people who've lost brothers or sisters. I mean, just tremendous, devastating hardship. Families got divorced or broke up, not having much of anything financially growing up. Everybody, but I've noticed those hardships make people better people, because it makes you humble. It makes you realize you have to work for every single thing you have. And I would tell the kids out there, hey, everybody can accomplish their dreams, because your dream is a personal dream. It is a goal and objective, yes, but more importantly, it is something you believe in. And I tell people, all you have to do to get to your dream is two things. You just have to work really hard. You know, I tell the kids, every time I have an opportunity to share with the next generation of leaders, I always say, remember that very simply, the key to success is hard work. That the harder you work, the better you do. The more you put in, the more you get out. It's that simple. Nobody anywhere gives you anything in this life that we have. Everything good, you have to work for. And it seems like the harder you work, the more rewarding success ultimately is. So that's number one. There's no shortcuts. There's no way around hard work. You've got to go right at it. And number two is, we cannot give up. We cannot give up on life, because bad things happen to good people. And sometimes life just isn't fair. I cannot explain it. It's beyond my understanding. I know it to be true, though. And the only way we can deal with that is by continuing to believe in our dreams. You know, that perseverance and commitment to your goal is paramount to getting there. That success is just getting up and dusting yourself off one more time than you fell down. And if you get up one more time, that's success. And the more you get up, dust yourself off, the better off you are. So it's really having a dream, and not someone else's dream. It has to be your dream. And any dream you have is a good dream. It can be a dream to play music, to sing, to dance, to practice medicine, to practice law, to teach, to coach, to open your own business, to know the heavens and the sciences, and or to be a leader and innovator in technology. Those are all good dreams. But what is more important than success and achievement of dreams is that on the way there, through the journey, that we remember the most important thing is to treat people with aloha and love. That there's no shortage of it. Sometimes we treat kindness and compassion like it's a finite amount, like it's $10 and I only can spend $9 and put $1 back in my pocket. No, aloha, love, compassion, kindness is limitless. It is an infinite amount. You can use as much as you possibly can use. You can give as much love as you can give today. And tomorrow when you wake up, you're full of love and aloha again. You know, talking about being bullied, I think all of us growing up have all encountered challenges. You know, some of us get teased because of what we wear, what we have, or what we don't have, you know. We get teased because we're not as fast, we're not as strong, or we're not as smart as other kids. When I was younger, I used to get teased and made fun of and bullied, and I lived in a neighborhood with a lot of older kids. And I lived a block away from a gym. So that's where you go after school. You know, you play basketball, we play kickball, we play baseball. But I'd always go play it, but there's a lot of older kids, you know, get teased, you know, had big ears. I used to get teased Dumbo, and, you know, you get pushed around, you get made fun of, or, you know, my parents didn't have a lot of money. They didn't have much money. We had a big family, 8 kids. So, you know, we made do with what we had. So I didn't have Nikes. You know, I didn't have Reebok. You know, we'd have no name brand shoes and sports equipment and get teased about that, you know, and sometimes it hurts and they cry and you run home. And had an interesting conversation one time with a classmate from law school. He was very quiet. But when he opened up, he was this really wonderful person. He was Filipino, and he grew up in Berkeley, California. And he said to not get picked on, he became very quiet. He tried to make himself invisible. But when he talked about how he felt, it was amazing because I was sitting there saying, I felt that exact same way. I'd hate being bullied. I'd be afraid of being bullied just walking into a situation, going to the field, walking into the gym. I'd just be like, my stomach would be sore and my heart would beat fast. But what was amazing was, whereas he tried to make himself invisible, I tried to make myself loud. I thought if I act loud and aggressive and a little bit crazy, maybe they wouldn't bully me, you know. But what is amazing is we both felt the same way. Nobody likes to be bullied. So my way against being bullied was to become very strong and aggressive and to defend myself. But I think my response was an overreaction to being bullied when I look back now. But, you know, I looked at, because you're scared. Everybody's scared. And then you realize that, hey, even the bully's scared. You know, that's why he won't bully. Because he's so scared, he wants to make other people afraid. And I learned that later on. And I never did like the bully. I remember having a special education student in my class. And I was 9th grade, and they were seniors, juniors, sophomores. I was scared, a lot of big, strong guys in class. And they were picking on him. And I thought, oh, no sin, don't say anything, because these are big, strong, older kids. But I was so offended that they were picking on him and laughing, making fun, that I stepped in and said, hey, why you guys got to pick on him? And then a guy grabbed me and he put me against the wall. He said, well, you like us pick on you? And I remember just sitting there going, well, better than picking on him, you know? And I just thought, wow, it's not cool. And I've never appreciated the bully. Hopefully, a bullying is a stage that kids go through and they grow out of, because parents are involved, teachers are involved, coaches are involved, family members are involved. We cannot look at bullying as just kids being kids, because kids who don't learn that bullying is wrong, mean, vicious, that it lacks aloha, love and respect. If kids don't learn that, they grow up to be adults who don't know that. And if we want to live in a world, in a community with love, respect, and aloha, then we have to instill those values in our children so they grow up with that. They're comfortable with it. They embrace it. I think what is our kids have to learn is that being humble is being strong. Helping other people is being strong. Being respectful of your teachers and your parents. Helping other people even when nobody is watching. That takes real strength. And true strength, strength that comes from within, that comes from God in whatever way, shape, or form you believe in. That strength is a strength to lift people up, not to push people down. You know, to make yourself feel bigger by making others feel smaller. That's not what it's all about. Then what it's really about is when you make somebody else feel better, you make somebody else feel stronger. That's true strength, and that's true love and aloha. I think that's what it's all about.